spin liquid state of pyrochlor and honeycomb lattices. So first, I'd like to talk about the emergent photons and monopoles in pyrochlor spin isostate of pyrochlor magnets. So the pyrochlor lattice is one of the three-dimensional highly frustrated systems. So here I'd like to talk about the this compound, praseodymium 2, zirconium 2, 07. So in ordinary water ice, hydrogen atoms are bonded to two oxygens strongly to the one and weakly to the other. So then two near and two far configuration is realized. So because of this ice rule, this ice rule gives rise to the large ground state degeneracy and gives rise to large residual entropies. So pyrochlor lattice is as shown here. So this is formed by the formed by corner shared tetrahedra, and in the rare earth pyrochlor magnets, rare earth magnetic moment of rare earth metal locates on the top of tetrahedron. then they interact with the ferromagnetically. So because of the crystal field effect, the magnetic moment of rare earths points along the 111 direction of the cubic lattice, cubic unit cell. So therefore, the magnetic moment act as the Ising spins. So as a consequence, one spin, two in, two out spin configuration is preferred. So this is very similar to the ice rule structure shown in the water ice. So then, so this configuration gives rise to the large ground state degeneracy. So such a spin ice correlation appears as a pinch point singularity in the momentum space, as shown here. So this is a so such a pinch point can be observed by inelastic neutron scattering experiments. So this is a inelastic neutron pattern in the momentum space obtained by the theory assuming the using the dipole model, and this is the experimental results for classical spin ice compounds. Holmium to titanium to 07. So as you can see, the spin point, pinch point singularity has been observed at this point clearly in the experiments. So then when the Hamiltonian have only Ising term, so the its ground state is found to be a classical spin ice state. So then in the ground state, the spin configuration is like this. So two spins pointing inward and the other pointing outward. So as I mentioned before, in the excited state is given by the spin flip of this spin, which give rise to the 3-in-1-out spin configuration and 1-in-3-out configurations. So this corresponds to the pair formation of magnetic monopoles here and which give rise to a B field through this equation. So today I will call a magnetic monopole as a M particle. So the excitation energy of a M particle is 2JZ. So 2JZ. So JZZ is found here. And then the classical M particle is dispersionless, as drawn in this figure. So thus the M particle propagate diffusively. So then, so such a diffusive modes cannot be detected by transport measurements. So in addition to the Ising term, so in real material systems, such as these compounds, so there is XY term exists as shown here. So the lowest order of the quantum fluctuation is the third order perturbation of this Hamiltonian. So then we obtain this kind of this effective Hamiltonian. So this corresponds to the ring exchange on the this hexagon, and so this generates the tunneling process between these two hexagons within the spin ice manifold. So this these are quantum fluctuations give lift the degeneracy of a classical spin ice manifold, leading to the quantum spin liquid ground state in this model. So the effective dynamics of the spin system can be mapped onto the electromagnetism, and this Hamiltonian can be described in this kind of form. So indeed, this is a Hamiltonian for the quantum electrodynamics within the U1 gauge theory. So here, E and A corresponds to the electric field and the vector potential, respectively. And both E and A corresponds to SG and S plus minus in this Hamiltonian. So these two are one-to-one kind of correspondence. Then, yes. Then as a result, quantum fluctuations change the elemental excitation dramatically, as shown here. So in addition to the M particle excitations, electric monopole, I call this E particle, and the photons, I call here this as a new particle, emerge from the spin ice, quantum spin ice manifold. So this is obtained from this kind of Hamiltonian. So let me discuss the elemental excitation in more details. So similar to the quantum classical spin ice, so sorry, in particle appears as a result of a spin flip. However, this M particle in quantum spin ice state has a dispersion due to the quantum fluctuation. So thus, this M particle can contribute to the transport. In contrast to the M particle, arising out, this M particle arising out from the spin ice manifold, so E and new particles emerges from within the spin ice manifold. So E particle is regarded as a topological defect, and the topological spin excitation represent the collective spin excitation perpendicular to the local easy axis. So then a new particle or photons is a coherent gapless excitations. And which mediate the dynamical interaction between the E and M particles. So I'd like to stress that the, these particles appear from this spin ice manifold due to the gauge field fluctuations because of Hamiltonian in this form. So then let me move on to the real material systems, Praseodymium 2, Zirconium 2, 07. So this materials does not show the long range magnetic order down to 50 millikelvin. And neutron scattering experiments reveal the presence of a pinch point. However, this pinch point is strongly broadened, shows a strong broadening even at low temperature, indicating the significant fluctuation in this system. pinch point reveals the presence of a spin ice correlation. So, and switch heat shows the broad anomaly at around 1 Kelvin. This corresponds to the M particle excitations. because the, this local cloud of moment of praseodymium atoms creates is forms the non-Clamart doublet. So this praseodymium ions creates a transverse component in the in addition to the this Ising term. So this it corresponds to the Hamiltonian as shown before. So from the specific heat measurement, we can estimate the exchange energy, JZZ and J plus minus, which are as large as 1 Kelvin and fifth of JZZ respectively. So however, from the heat capacity measurement, E and the new particles have not been detected because of their significant nuclear heat capacity at low temperature. So therefore, the thermal conductivity has been measured. So because the thermal conductivity is very sensitive probe for the low energy itinerant excitations. So here shows the thermal conductivity divided by temperature as a function of temperature. So here data is plotted in log-log scale. So as you can see, there are characteristic temperature dependence. So we can divide three parts, region 1, 2, and 3. So in these characteristic temperature regime, so the field dependence of thermal conductivity also shows the characteristic behavior. So in region 3, thermal conductivity shows decreases with increasing temperature, while the it shows almost constant in region 2. On the other hand, thermal conductivity shows increase with increasing magnetic field in region 1. So this may reflect the different crystal particle excitation in these three temperature regions. So in zero field, in region 3, so RNS fit of the thermal conductivity shows the in region 3, here we plot the thermal conductivity in log of thermal conductivity and as a function of inverse inverse of temperature. So from this RNS fit, we can estimate the gap energy of crystal particle excitations. So then we can estimate the gap energy as large as 6 Kelvin. So this energy is the same order as the M particle pair creation energy, which is as large as 4 Kelvin. So therefore, this steep increase of thermal conductivity at high temperature can be attributed to the M particle or excitations. So in the intermediate temperature regime 2, we found some characteristic temperature dependence at around 700 millikelvin. So this can be clearly seen in the temperature derivative of thermal conductivity plotted in the by the green line. So so this temperature derivative shows the dip at around this temperature. So this temperature is very close to the excitation energy of E particle, which is estimated to be 400 millikelvin. Thus, we are attributed this structure of kappa xy due to the E particle excitations. Then finally, in regime 1, the thermal conductivity shows a steep enhancement with decreasing temperature and shows a peak, then decreases. I'd like to stress that this sharp upturn cannot be attributed to the phonon and the M particle excitations because of the following reasons. So in this temperature region, low temperature region, phonon thermal conductivity, phonon thermal conductivity is limited by the boundary scattering. So in other words, the phonon mean free path reach to the sample side. So therefore, so we cannot expect this kind of enhancement at low temperatures. For M particles, so since the gap energy of M particles is much larger than the 0.2 Kelvin, so M particle cannot enhance the thermal conductivity at this low temperature. So then, so this thermal conductivity shows the this upturn is shows the so T to the minus two dependence, so which is very similar to the so phonon thermal conductivity at high temperature, and this peak at very low temperature. So and this peak is corresponds to the some indicates that the quasi-particle mean free path leads to the some sample boundary, so indicating that the highly mobile quasi-particle excitations. But this cannot be a phonon, so therefore we conclude that the this peak originated from the new particle, photon excitation. So from these characteristic temperature dependence of thermal conductivity, so we identified that the spin quasi-particle excitation in this quantum spin-ice materials that is M particle, E particle, and new particle or new particles, respectively. All right, from such a in the quantum spin liquid state in the pyroclone magnet with the spin ice correlations, so we found the these characteristic emergent quasi particle excitations which are expected in such a system. Okay, then in the last as a last topic, so I'd like to talk about the Majorana fermions and half integer thermal quantum Hall effect in Honeycomb magnets. So recently, kick-type spin model has attracted much attention as an exactly solvable model of the quantum spin liquids. So this is a Hamiltonian of the kick-type model, and this model is for half spins on tri-coordinate lattices, as shown here. So the interaction between spins is a so-called Kitaev interaction. So Ising like exchange interaction along the bond directions. So at the given side, the exchange interaction along these three bond direction cannot be satisfied simultaneously, giving rise to exchange frustrations, which is very different from the conventional geometrical frustrations. So the example of tri-coordinate lattices includes two-dimensional honeycomb lattice and the three-dimensional hyper honeycomb lattice. So in this model, spins each spins can be a remarkable feature of this model is that the each spins can be represented by the Majorana fermions. For example, so here we represent the quantum spins by four kinds of Majorana fermions: Bx, By, Bz, C, under this constraint. So, as you know, minor fermions is a particles that are on antiparticle. So this can be seen from this relationships. So by introducing a bond operator U, which are represented by a product of B minor fermions, so this U commute with the Hamiltonian. Then its eigenvalues are plus minus one, which are the local conserved quantities. Using this U, this Hamiltonian can be represented by the quadratic, using this U, Hamiltonian can be rewritten like this. So quadratic Hamiltonian with respect to the free Majorana fermion C. So this quadratic form of fermion Hamiltonian can be solved exactly. Then bracket operator shown here and defined in one bracket also commute with the Hamiltonian, and their eigenvalues values are plus minus one. So this is also the local conserved quantities. So in the ground state, all bracket has a bracket value plus one. In the excited state, so the system has a bracket with a minus one. And then using this anti-commute relationship between the bracket operator and the Pauli matrices, so we can calculate the spin correlations using this formula. Then we can find that the spin correlation is finite only in the nearest neighbor bonds. So this is actually a definition of a quantum spin leakage. So ground state of Kitaev model is found to be exactly found to be a quantum spin leakage. Then at high temperatures, the system is in the paramagnetic state. But with the decreasing temperature, spin half is fractionalized into the itinerant Majorana fermions, and these fluxes consist of localized Majorana fermion B. So, here both itinerant Majorana fermions and the G2 fluxes are excited and interact with each other. So such a fractionalization appears below the characteristic temperature of Kitaev interaction. Then at much lower temperature, close to the zero Kelvin, close to zero, so there's no flux excitation, and the system becomes the quantum spin leakage state. Oh, sorry. So there are two types of spin leakage ground state, depending on the anisotropy of Kitaev interaction. So this is the phase diagram with respect to the Kitaev interaction for the three bond directions. So there are two A and B is a different quantum spin leakage ground state, and where A is gapless. A is gapped. but B is gapless. And a remarkable feature is that the, in the gapless spin liquid state, Majorana fermions has a massless Dirac cone, and such Dirac cone appears in the, at the corner of, at the corner of brilliant zone. So actually, this structure is very similar to the that of graphene. But here, Dirac cone is not is formed by Majorana fermions, not electrons. So in this talk, I'd like to focus on the this B phase, gapless quantum spin liquid. So in the so next, I'd like to discuss the effect of magnetic field in the to the quantum liquid spin liquid state in the B phase. So in zero field, Majorana fermions, so actually itinerant Majorana fermions has a massless Dirac cone, as I mentioned. Then, so magnetic field breaks the time reversal symmetry, leading to the gap opening in the, this Dirac cone. So according to the perturbation theory, first order term is zero because of the spin liquid ground state with no magnetic moment. So this first order term do not break the time reversal symmetry. So and the second order term do not break the time reversal symmetry also. And the third order term breaks the time reversal symmetry, giving rise to the gap opening. So this third order term corresponds to the second nearest neighbor hopping of Majorana fermions in the, on the honeycomb lattices. So this situation is very similar to the famous Halden model for quantum Hall effect in electron systems. Therefore, the Majorana fermion system under magnetic field can be characterized by the topological Chan number, which give rise to the chiral edge current of Majorana fermions. So, in quantum Hall effect, edge currents, normal, not usual perturbation theory, not non-linear theory. So in the quantum Hall effect, edge currents are carried by electrons or anions in the integer and fractional quantum Hall effect, respectively. So in this state, electrical Hall conductance and thermal Hall conductance are quantized, as shown here. So I'd like to emphasize that the thermal Hall conductance in the case of abelian state of fractional quantum Hall states, thermal Hall conductance are quantized integer multiple of the these units. This is in contrast to the electrical Hall conductance in which the which is a quantized fractional multiple of this unit in the quantum Hall fractional quantum Hall states. So in magnets, edge currents are carried by charge neutral Majorana fermions. Because of this charge neutrality, only thermal Hall conductance can be quantized. The remarkable feature is that some Hall conductance is counted half multiple of this unit. So this is because the degree of freedom of Majorana fermions is half of the conventional fermions. Moreover, this half integer quantization provides strong evidence for the non-abelian ground state. So, therefore, this, okay. Then, in real material systems, real systems are spin orbit assisted MOT insulator with effective magnetic moment J half is provide provide a platform for the Kitaev model. In these materials, so the 5D 45 or 5D5 the orbitals are split by the crystal field effect, and this state is further split by the spin orbit coupling. So the half field state is with effective J half is realized in the system. So while the band widths of D5 materials are relatively large, but just by a small, because of this splitting, band widths become narrowed, and then just by a small perturbation of U, so Coulomb energy, the system can be MOT insulator with spin half. And recently it has been shown that the Kitaev interaction arises from partially filled G2 level here in the presence of spin orbit coupling, especially in the crystal structure as shown here. In this case, super exchange interaction these two paths has a destructive interaction and cancel out. Then, magnetic interaction become bond is a bond dependent as expected in the Kitaev model. Okay, the materials with such electronic structure and crystal structure are reported in these 5 years, and so as shown here. So among them, alpha leucine trichloride is suggested as a strong candidate for realizing the Kitaev model. Quantum spin liquid. So this is a crystal structure of alpha ruthenium trichloride, and ruthenium atoms form the two-dimensional honeycomb lattices. So this two-dimensional honeycomb plane stacked along the weakly stacked along the c-axis by a weak van der Waals interaction. So, however, in real materials, it has been shown that Kitaev interaction plays an important role in this material, and actually, the magnitude of Kitaev interaction is estimated to be 80 Kelvin. However, because of the presence of Heisenberg and off-diagonal exchange interaction in real materials, so anti-ferromagnetic order appears at 7 Kelvin. So in this materials, unusual magnetic excitation In fact, actually, magnetic continuum has been reported below the characteristic temperature of Kitaev interaction. So this is a result of Raman scattering and neuralgic neutron scattering. And as you can see, a broad excitation, magnetic continuum appears at the gamma point. And gamma point. Oh, okay. So this is experimental data, and this is a result of theoretical calculation. And as you can see, experimental data are well reproduced by the theory based on the pure Kitaev model, neglecting the Heisenberg or other interaction and so on. So therefore, this magnetic continuum is discussed as a signature of Majorana fermion excitations. However, such a broad continuum can appear even by the conventional magnon excitations. This interpretation is still controversial. So to overcome such an issue, it's very important to search the possible half-integer quantized summer hole conductance, because it provides strong evidence for the presence of Majorana fermions. So recently, it has been shown that the in-plane magnetic field kills the magnetic order in zero field. The Tn is almost zero in the applied parallel magnetic field of 7 Tesla. Inelastic neutron scattering reported the broad continuum even above the critical field at low temperature. So this continuum is very similar to that observed in zero field above near temperature. So these results indicate some exotic spin liquid state is realized at high magnetic field at low temperatures. So search the quantum summer Hall effect, we measure the summer Hall effect in the tilted magnetic field. So since the field, we need a high magnetic field, 7 Tesla, to suppress the near temperature. It is difficult to control the parallel field and perpendicular field separately. So we apply the magnetic field, tilted away from the C-axis, and swept magnetic field. So in this case, anti-fermionic order is suppressed by an in-plane field component, as you can see in this figure. So this is a result for a different field angle. And the sum hole response is determined by the perpendicular field component. Then this is a result for summer hole conductivity as a function of both perpendicular and parallel magnetic field. Both are changed simultaneously because this is a tilted field experiment. So here I calculated the two-dimensional summer hole conductance per two-dimensional honeycomb layer. As you can see, summer hole conductance is almost zero in the anti-ferromagnetically ordered state. But kappa xy is dramatically enhanced above the critical field. Remarkably, the summer hole conductance shows a plateau the function of a magnetic field demonstrating some quantum plateau. And most surprisingly, this plateau value is exactly half of the the quantization value expected in the integer quantum Hall effect. So demonstrating the half integer quantized thermal Hall conductance. So this is a result for a different temperature, and it's the plateau preserves up to 5 Kelvin, but the kappa xi value become larger than the half integer and disappears at about the 5 Kelvin. So this plateau is observed in different samples and different field angle. So so the quantum plateau is well reproduced in these in these conditions. So here I'd like to stress that the that this quantization of some Hall effect is observed in the charged insulator with no charge degree of freedom. So the H current related associated with the quantum Hall effect is the carried by charged neutral quasi particles. This is remarkable because the quantum Hall effect is usually observed in the electron two-dimensional electronic systems. Next, so quantized plateau indicates the thermal Hall conductance is not does not depend on the details of a sample, or for example, sample size, the cleanness of H, and the so and the thermal Hall conductance is not affected by the scattering. So this means that the plateau provides evidence for topological protection of the H state. And third, so half-integer quantization indicates the degree of freedom of electrons, quasi particles, half of those of conventional fermions. So therefore, this observation provides strong evidence for chiral Majorana H current. So in the, this is a temperature dependence in the plateau regime, and the plateau preserved up to 5 Kelvin and increases with increasing temperature and disappears at 60 Kelvin. Which is close to the energy scale of Kitaev interaction. So actually, this this is consistent for the expectation for the Majorana fermions in Kitaev model. And according to the theoretical calculations, this quantized plateau appears below the energy scale of flux gap, which is estimated as large as 5 Kelvin, according to this theoretical paper, so which is consistent with the observations. So finally, let me remind you that thermal Hall conductance disappears at is strongly reduced with increasing temperature and becomes zero at high magnetic field. So this implies the disappearance of a topologically protected edge state at the high magnetic field. So this disappearance indicates, suggests the presence of some topological phase transition at this field. At this field. So because the at this field region, magnetic system is not polarized because the magnetization is still smaller than 1/3 of saturation magnetization. This state is not a spin polarized state, but maybe some kind of a topologically trivial spin leakage state. Anyway, so this may suggest the topological phase transition from non-topologically non-trivial state to a topologically trivial state. So then summarizing the result, in between the magnetically ordered state and the non-topological spin leakage state, there is a Kitaev quantum spin leakage state, which is evidenced by the observation of a half-integer quantized Sommer Hall conductance. Recently, such a Kyle-Meyer-H mode have been reported in a heterostructure of a superconductor and a quantum anomalous Hall insulator, and even denominator fractional quantum Hall systems, where the in this case half-integer longitudinal electrical conductance, not Hall conductance, it's observed. And in this case, half integer, but it's not half, five half of the multiple of the this unit is observed. So, the interpretation of Meyer fermions or H mode in this system is still controversial, and there's a lot of discussion of the exact ground state of this system, because in the conventional framework, we cannot expect the half integer of this value. So usually three halves or seven halves are expected. So five halves are very exotic. Anyway, there are a lot of remarkable difference between this system and the Kitaev quantum spin leakage. So first, Meyer fermions appears not only in the bulk, but also in the edge. The other way around. Not only in the edge, but also the bulk. In zero field, Meyer fermion appears in the bulk in Kitaev quantum spin leakage. So, the observed quantization temperature is 5 Kelvin, so which is remarkably high compared to this system. So quantization appears at very low temperature, about 20 Kelvin. So our result is one or two order higher than those systems. Moreover, in our cases, H modes are carried only by the Meyer fermions. This is in contrast to this system, where not only the Meyer fermions, but also the other modes, like electrons or anions, carry the H mode. Okay, let me summarize. By measuring the thermal Hall effect in Kitaev material candidate, ruthenium trichloride, the half-integer quantum thermal Hall effect is observed, which provides the this direct signature of Meyer H modes. And so since the quantization arises from the charge neutral modes, so this new type of quantum Hall effect. Observation of quantum Hall effect it provides the evidence of the topological nature of quantum spin leakage state, which has never been reported so far. Okay, and the sudden disappearance of quantum Sommer Hall plateau at high field suggest the presence of topological transition or crossover. Remaining question is the influence of non-Kitaev interaction on quantization interaction, which is present in real material systems. And also, nature of non-topological phase at higher field is still unclear. So these two are future issues. Okay, by thermal conductivity and thermal hole conductivity, so several new type of emergent crystal particle excitations are detected in quantum spin ice and Kitaev quantum spin liquid. Okay, thank you for your attention.